Welcome back. Now let's have a look at sports, whereby athletes currently in bubble training camp at Kasarani in preparation for the 32nd Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games will remain in camp waiting for further directive from the Ministry of Sports. According to Team Kenya General Manager Barnabas Korir, Athletics Kenya is consulting with the Ministry of Sports to advise on the way forward following President Uhuru Kenyatta's directive yesterday of suspending all sporting activities in the country. The athletes currently in bubble training camp at Kasarani in preparation for the 32nd Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games will remain in camp waiting for further directive from the Ministry of Sports.
The bubble training here in Kasarani were mainly for the sprinters. Those the sprinters, we were putting together a team for the world relays. And on top of that, also, we have a few field events, especially one athlete for the javelin and three for walking race. And those ones were specifically preparing for the Olympics. Now, these athletes, the idea was to make sure that they qualify not only for the world relays, but also for the Olympics, and that's why we had worked a plan with the National Olympic Committee to support them and ensure that we get a team that would qualify for both events.
The team, comprising of 105 athletes who are in bubble training ahead of the Games, including sprint athletes, taekwondo athletes, as well as four boxers, will rejoin the camp on arrival from DR Congo, and the men and women rugby teams who left the country for Dubai Invitation Sevens. Meanwhile, Athletics Kenya will announce the way forward on selection of Team Kenya for the World Relays in Poland and the African Senior Athletics Championships following suspension of all sporting activities.
It means that if there is no preparation, if there is no, nothing going on in the organization, that means that we are not in this competition. So, definitely there has to be a way of ensuring that we have a proper training and also control selection, because that's the only way. And we just don't want to go and participate in those games. We want to go and compete. So the earlier they sit down and discuss the way forward, the better for our country.
Korir, who is also Athletics Kenya executive member, say they will make a decision on whether to send a team to Poland between 1st and 2nd May or withdraw from the event.
As for the local athletes, it is really devastating for them. They had given, been given an opportunity to compete, especially the weekend meets. We have had also organized that. We did organize in November last year for the youth in preparation for the World Under 20. And now everything is gone in smoke, and we want to see now what is the best way. We are also having the World Under 20 preparation that will be taking place in August. Now everything is in limbo. As time goes, we will know exactly what we need to do.
Following the president's directive yesterday, sports federations in the country have suspended all leagues indefinitely, among them the Kenya Rugby Union, which has suspended the Kenya Cup, Football Kenya Federation, which has suspended all its leagues, and the Machakos Rally, which was to be held tomorrow, has also been cancelled.